Welcome to this session B, 6B, still on the biowaste, waste to energy, wastewater, and the fecal sludge management team. My name is Oluwaseola Afolabi, and I have my colleague here, Tanya Radu, will be facilitating this session. Can I just request that if you have a Twitter account and you'd like to tweet something of interest, please start with please use the ash word, WEDEC 42. Right, we have two presenters for this session. We're going to change the order slightly. We're going to start with Dimka Olumana. I'm not sure if he's part of the participants. Right.
Not at the moment.
Right. There is a bit of a problem with his presentation because it's just 55 seconds, but I think regardless, we could play it. And if you have any particular question, please use the chat box, because we've found from the fourth session that that's the best way to get your questions across. So I'm going to start with this session. Effectiveness of Typha latifolia for phytoremediation of hazardous heavy metal in wastewater.
The deposition of heavy metals into water. So treating wastewater and the combination. The objective of this study was to evaluate the effect. The study area, it was done in Oakland Park. The contaminant concentrations were measured. Then the effectiveness of the results are indicated.
Yeah.
As a conclusion recommendation, the result. Thank you very much.
Right, that's. I think there's something wrong with the presentation. So I would. I think I could see Dimka online. Yes. Please accept my video. I'm going to change to discussion mode. If you can kindly accept my video, then we can have the opportunity to hear the presentation from you in person. Can you
can you hear me, please?
Yes, we can hear you.
The presentation was already, it has no problem. I don't know why it's not coming properly.
Yeah, but that will give us the opportunity to hear the presentation from you directly, if that is okay.
Okay, because I didn't expect it. Let me open. So do you, I don't know how to link it, so I've just presented. There is some echo, I don't know.
I'm not sure if you are able to. Let me see, only participant presenters can talk. No, let's see, discussion mode. I think there is something probably wrong with the video. So I think if you can just run us through the presentation, that will be helpful.
Okay, let me present it. My presentation is on the effectiveness of Typha latifolia for phytoremediation of hazardous heavy metals in wastewater. So I'm the associate professor at the University of Johannesburg. So the deposition of heavy metals into water bodies in the soil from different activities have adverse effects on human health, biodiversity, and aquatic life. there is a major concern to human health and ecosystem. So the treated wastewater and the completely remove or minimize the concentration of hazardous and heavy metals in wastewater is very important. So we try to eliminate the impact of heavy metals and improve the quality of life. Is it okay? Shall I continue?
Yes, please continue. We can see your video is corrupt, so please just present.
Okay, so the phytoremediation is one of the many technologies that have been employed in different parts of the world. So the objective of this study was to evaluate the effectiveness of Typha latifolia for the phytoremediation and the metal extractions. The study area was Auckland Park Industrial Area in Johannesburg. The procedures followed are indicated. The wastewater samples were placed in appropriate container. And then the plant species was placed in each of the samples. The samples are then left for 18 days before removal of the plants for analysis. The plants were rinsed with distilled water to wash off any soil particles. Then the contaminants concentrations were measured. Then the removal percentage were calculated as indicated in the formula. And then the effectiveness of the plant species were calculated based on the phytoremediation indices, like the bioconcentration factor, the translation or mobilization factor, and enrichment coefficients. There is a discussion, it is indicated here. The removal percentage for each metals were indicated. Of course, the percentage removal rate is between 70 to 80% for iron, copper, and chromium. It's more than 99% for aluminum, cadmium, lead, etc. The TFF, the translocation factor, less than one, except for iron. That means there is greatest accumulation was found in the roots and the plants than the parameters were not successfully translocated to the shoots and the leaves of the plants. The EC is less than one for all parameters. That means the heavy metals considered, that means there's greater concentration at the selected site than in the roots and the shoots of the plants. The EC already indicated there is a greater concentration at the selected site than the roots and the shoots of the plants. As a conclusion, the result indicated that the selected plant species is both accumulator and excluder of the heavy plants, sorry, the heavy metals. The percentage removal rate is between 17 to 80% for some parameters, and that's more than 99% for the other parameters. Of course, other plant species are also recommended for the remediation of the heavy metals from the wastewater. Thank you very much.
Do we have, thank you very much, Dinka, for having to improvise.
The results are indicated.
Sorry, I guess these are the key results. Okay. Yeah. Over to everyone. Any question for Dinka? Tanya, any question?
Yes. Dinka, thank you very much for your presentation, and I'm very sorry that we had to improvise. Can you hear me okay?
Yes, I can.
Good. So can you maybe comment a little bit on the what would you do with this contaminated biomass if you are to use plants for extraction of heavy metals from wastewater? You will end up with biomass which is contaminated by the same metals. So what would be the fate of this biomass? Do you have any suggestions of how would you then handle that contaminated biomass?
Okay, I've been thinking about that because this is a controlled experiment which was done in the controlled environment within the university. So I think that the biomass can be used for other purposes. For example, I think it can also be these plant species can be consumed by animals, and also
it be toxic to animals.
Of course, we have to check the toxic level before we feed it to the animals.
Yeah, I would suggest you do that.
Okay. Yeah, that's a good recommendation. I will check it then. Thank you very much.
Yes.
Yeah. Can you hear me, Dinko?
Yes, I can.
Yeah, unfortunately, as a result of the improvisation, it's difficult for us to have the discussion mode where we can encourage everyone to contribute while at the same time we present your results on the slide so that people can see. But I think I'm quite interested in why iron's performance is different. Is there any particular, the tier for iron seems to be greater than one. Is there any particular reason for that?
Let me check the iron. Let me check. Iron and even aluminium also, the BCF value is greater than one. That means this plant species is not effective in removing iron from the wastewater. They remain in the site, mostly.
Yeah, is there any reason for it where it has a preferential... why it preferentially excluded the uptake of iron? Because one would think that of all the metals, that should probably be one of those. Is there any?
Probably it is due to their solubility.
Right.
Yeah, iron might not be more soluble with other materials or with water. That might be the reason, but I will check the other reasons probably.
Okay. Any question for Dinko? I think we could switch to, let me see the results. Okay. Based on, I mean, looking at this, your recommendation, is this the only plant you've investigated your research with? Have you compared with other kind of species before? I know you mentioned options here, but I mean, from your experience.
Yeah, there is another study also done by my students. We also consider another plant species, these recommendations are based on the effectiveness of these plants for the phytoremediation purposes. That's based on literature only.
Right.
Is this locally available plant?
Yeah, they are locally available plants, and I think we can test and check it also. We checked already water lettuce. And they found to be more effective than the others.
Switch to discussion mode. Any contribution or observation or question from anyone? The floor is open. There is a video audio recording there. Okay, I can hear that. Any other question, Tanya? Or you? Right. Okay. Right. Okay. It's. I think we can move on to the next presentation. Actually, so if I go back to presentation mode. That's fine. So the second presentation is from right. The first presentation actually, which is now going to be our second, is from Giovanni Pedron and looking into non-conventional water reuse in agriculture, a project in Palestine.
Non-conventional water reuse in agriculture, an AWARA project in Palestine. Center for New Water Technology is a public foundation of the Andalusia Regional Ministry of Agriculture, Livestock, Fisheries and Sustainable Development, registered as a research center and entity for the transfer of technology and knowledge, promoting better management of water resources with an innovative, sustainable and supportive approach. WeWorkGVC is an Italian secular independent organization working since 1971 in international cooperation and humanitarian aid. In Palestine since 1992, focusing on guaranteeing access to water, sanitation and hygiene services and promoting local socioeconomic development and protection with a humanitarian development nexus approach. Across the world, improved and innovative sustainable management and reuse of treated wastewater have begun to be considered as an urgent priority to cope with demand growth of fresh water, especially in the context where limited water resources are stressed by over-abstraction, pollution, political constraints, and climate change. In this regard, the agricultural sector is responsible for 70% of the water abstraction worldwide, and a large increase in water demand are predicted for industry and energy production as well. Unfortunately, according to UNESCO, it is estimated that well over 80% of the wastewater worldwide, over 95% in some developing countries, is released into the environment without treatment. Concerning this, Palestine represents a so-called water-scarce territory facing a significant and growing shortage in the water supply. The actual Palestinian share from the three regional groundwater aquifers is 87 million cubic meters per year. This quantity is insufficient to meet the water demand of 2.65 million inhabitants of the West Bank. Additionally, inadequate management and outdated infrastructure characterize the Palestinian wastewater treatment sector. According to the Palestinian Water Authority, about 66 million cubic meters per year of wastewater are generated in Palestine, of which 36 in the West Bank and 30 in the Gaza Strip. In the West Bank, the current treatment capacity of wastewater amounts just to 4.5 million cubic meters per year. In line with national priorities, the European Union-funded project MENAWARA is considered as a framework to experiment innovative and sustainable technologies for non-conventional reuse of water in five Mediterranean countries. Specifically, in Palestine, the initiative is contributing to increase the percentage of treated and reused water in Nablus Governorate by the rehabilitation of a conventional activity sludge wastewater treatment plant located in the farmer community of Beidajan. The project was designed to enhance access to water for agricultural use, to the treatment of wastewater to be reused as complementary irrigation. Also, at the same time, strengthening the management and technical capacity of governmental institutions, non-state actors, technicians and farmers. Beidajan Wastewater Treatment Plant is considered a conventional activity sludge, whose main components of the existing electromechanical system are manual screen, influent pumping station, conventional preliminary treatment, activated sludge tank, secondary clarifier, chlorination unit. The current technical status of the plant does not allow the production of treated wastewater according to the national parameters, and thus it requires multiple interventions to reestablish its operativity. First, the installation of an innovative pretreatment compact system for screenings and removal and degreasing of wastewater. Secondly, for water reclamation, according to the principle fit for purpose, is foreseen a post-treatment train based on a filtration process using pressure sand filter and a subsequent disinfection stage by application of chlorine as a disinfecting agent. The reclaimed water will meet finally the quality required for irrigation of target crops, according to the Palestinian standard on effluent for agricultural irrigation. The irrigation system supplied also through the project will enhance local agricultural practices, allowing to build upon a water governance model around the establishment of a former water user association, with high replicability for neighboring farming communities. Positive impacts are expected on the livelihood of all community members toward the concept of the living lab. The first main innovation is represented by the installation of a pretreatment compact system for screening, sand removal and degreasing of the wastewater. Thanks to the modular structure, it will be assembled directly on site and the machine can be run manually or automatically and present easy maintenance. In more details, this figure shows some of those previously mentioned innovations. The assembly direct on site, thanks to the modular structure. Easy maintenance, thanks to the numerous edges of inspection. Grease scraper with limited elimination of water. And finally, the scroll bars bolted. All functions of the pretreatment compact system are controlled by a control panel that consists of a section of power and access of automation. If the automatic mode is selected, the plant is controlled by the PLC through a supervision program. The control panel will be equipped with a smart monitoring system that will allow to visualize the panel of the wastewater treatment plant and the working parameters directly from the browser. It will be also possible to visualize the information with a free application that can be downloaded on computers and smartphones. An additional innovation is represented by the establishment of a living lab in Beidajan community. Living labs are both practice-driven organizations that facilitate and foster open collaborative innovation as well as real-life environment arenas. Living labs operate as intermediaries among citizen, research organizations, companies, cities and regions for joint value co-creation, rapid prototyping or validation to scale up innovation and businesses. In a living lab, the aim is to accomplish the quadriplegics by harmonizing the innovation process among four main stakeholders: companies, users, public organizations, and researchers. Specifically, in the framework of Menawara project, six intervention sites in Palestine, Tunisia, Italy, Spain, and Jordan are foreseen to turn in open living labs, open laboratories, and peer-to-peer learning spaces, where youth, technicians, water user association, local farmers and local authorities will be trained on capitalizing on innovative and user-oriented wastewater treatment, reuse and irrigation technologies. The future steps of Menawara project in Palestine will encompass the establishment of a farmer user association for the management of the operation and maintenance of the irrigation network, the collection of the water fees and the division of the water shares. Moreover, the initiative foresees the collaboration with many local universities and local researchers, performing innovative studies on soil, water quality and irrigation. Additionally, it will be ensured the involvement of the most experienced local company for the habilitation of the treatment plant, providing innovation and fostering the dialogue with the operator of the treatment plant. Lastly, the project fostered the engagement of local authorities and ministries, enhancing governance and regulation regarding the wastewater sector in Palestine. Thank you for the attention.
Known conventional and local agriculture, Menawara project in Palestine. Center for New is a public
right, thank you very much. Okay, I think, yeah. Thank you very much. I think we could switch back here. Alanta Pedron. Right. Giovanni.
Hi. Sorry for being late. Unfortunately, I was attending another section where we actually also presented a paper. Well, nice to meet you all. I'm Giovanni Pedron from WeWork GVC Palestine. Actually, today I'm replacing Isabel Martin, which is the main author of the paper Menawara, because unfortunately she suffered an accident some days ago. So actually, I'm I will try to make my best.
Thank you very much for the interesting presentation. Before I probably ask my question, anyone from the audience? I think anyone can chip in now. It's a discussion session. I'll start with Tanya. I know you have questions, so
stop picking on me so long. Okay, Giovanni. I have one question regarding the use of that wastewater that you are treating. So you said that the main use is irrigation. So is that the main goal of the project, providing water for irrigation, or is that just one of the options in terms of water use? Because you can obviously achieve such standard of final effluent quality to use it for various other purposes. So can you just comment on that a little bit? Why only irrigation, and if there are any other possibilities?
Absolutely. Thank you. Thank you for the question, actually. Yes, in this case, we are focused on providing innovation for the reuse of safe water treatment by different kind of, for example, pilots and in innovative station. In the case of Palestine, we are talking about, as in the presentation, we already mentioned an activated sludge treatment plant. So basically, the main goal, of course, is actually providing water for irrigation systems. Also, because in the case of the West Bank of Palestine, as we probably all know, we are talking about a water scarce territory, where actually the cost of water is very high. We're talking about around more than actually 1 euro per cubic meter. So based on everyone can make calculation and make comparison according to where it is in there. But in any case, we're talking about an high price. So it's extremely important and became actually very urgent to find secondary and innovative stores of water, especially for agriculture, but not exclusively, since actually in Palestine, Menawara and the rehabilitation of the treatment plant in Beit Lajan is part of more integrated approach proposed by PWA, the Water Authority, towards actually change in management of the wastewater. So we are talking about a component in a wider program that is already ongoing.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Well, thanks. My question is just around the if there is any kind of water parameter assessment, and if that are within the maximum allowable concentration for you to use them for irrigation. Do you do that as part of this project?
Absolutely, yes. What we are trying to actually to do is, of course, controlling the influent and the outfluent in each time, in each actually section of the plant, considering the fact that our goal is serving plots, fields that are cultivating especially lemon and olives. So the parameters that will be achieved will obviously respect the national parameters, which are more or less standardized to the European one, actually. But in any case, we are actually targeting olives and lemon trees. So water will not be directly connected to, for example, vegetables fields, which will require further actually purification, further treating. That might be considered in the future, because in any case the capacity of the plant might be extended from the current situation, also thanks to the intervention that we are performing. Therefore, it's actually an open discussion, but In order to answer to your question, absolutely. I mean, parameters are controlled deeply and constantly, and it will be controlled also with the support of local authorities and the creation of the Farmer Water User Association, which will be established through the project and will be in charge also from such kind of controls.
The interesting thing about water reuse, particularly, correct me if I'm wrong, in that kind of area, is there could be some social barrier to adopting wastewater reuse, particularly for agricultural use. Have you experienced any kind of...
I actually fully agree with your point of view, and definitely we experience similar issues. I will not call it problem, because in any case, it's related to a cultural perspective and to a cultural point of view. In the specific case of Bidjan, actually, the treatment plant was already existing. So farmers were already kind of used to adopt the reuse of treated water. But actually, there are some other farmers that will be served by the treatment plant that will be targeted in this sense, actually, by a kind of capacity building regarding actually the importance of the reuse of water, and effectively the fact that the waste water, it can be considered pure. So we have to separate the concept of sludge from the concept of treated water. It's extremely important. And obviously, I mean, it has actually some problem related to the cultural and religious also perspective that can influence. I feel, frankly speaking, that it's not actually something related to the users of this water, but it's more related to the final consumer. So the most important things, in my opinion, once which is achieved actually a common perspective regarding the use of the water among the farmers, is scaling up and trying actually to targeting final user, which should know and which should be aware about the fact that they are consuming and purchasing a product that has been irrigated with the water. In this way, we are creating a kind of chain of consciousness and awareness, which is extremely important. And this is actually what we are trying to do also with Menawara, with the concept of living in love. Because actually something important is that once the intervention is done, we will not leave actually the Farming User Association stand alone, but we'll enhance the creation of a kind of discussion internally to the community, where, for example, also some actors that are not directly involved in the use or the treating of the water might be targeted. For example, with the products that we are actually in cultivating, olives and lemons, we can create sub-products, which means oil, for example, or for example, sub-products from lemon juice.
Right. Okay. Thanks very much for your answers. I'm going to open the floor. I think if you have any question, you could please feel free to ask or type your question or bedroom.
Yeah, I actually don't see any question in the chat for the moment.
No. I've not seen any question in the chat. I'm monitoring that. Anyone, any question for Pedro?
Jeremy, right. where is that wastewater coming from, the one that you're treating it?
We're talking about domestic wastewater. So basically, the village that we are targeting is a 2,000 people, medium-sized village, I would say, which is actually the most common size in the West Bank. And it does not have any presence of, for example, heavy metals.
But is that combined gray water with human yes. waste?
Sorry, yes. It is combined actually. So in some moment of the year, the quality of the water actually it increase or it decrease in function and in to the quantity of rain, because also we're talking about also the fact that unfortunately the two systems are combined. So at the inlet it arrive also gray water together with the water rain.
All right. There's a question here from Danik. He said, what do you mean by living labs?
Thanks for the question. Actually, living lab is a concept. We can call it, I mean, it's actually a laboratory, and a human being laboratory, where many components of the society, starting from the beneficiaries in this case, or the users, or the agriculturists, the companies, the local authorities, are involved and engaged in ongoing discussion. It means that basically creating a network where local actors are in a peer-to-peer discussion, and they can, for example, raise issues, manage problems, understanding how to solve actual situation, and providing ideas, or for example, creating new job opportunities or startup connected to the treatment system of the water. So Living Lab is a kind of new concept introduced some years ago, which is taking place a lot in Palestine, but not exclusively. And is actually, it must be performed with in different way. Our approach is actually starting from the Farmer Water Youth Association, connecting it to the local authorities at local level, but also at ministries, because we are of course involved in the Palestinian Authority, and fostering and triggering the discussion. So it would be, practically speaking, it would be actually a kind of group of people that will meet up several times during the years to evaluate actually the condition and situation regarding the reuse of water, and it will be the possibility towards and around the reuse of water.
Right. Okay. Thank you very much. I think we have another question here from David Galibog. Do you consider emerging pollutants in your work? And what kind of emerging pollutants? That's a serious question.
Thank you. So we are quite lucky in this case, because there's not any kind of industry in the area. Beit Dajane is a fully rural area in the middle of the West Bank. So basically, we perform water quality analysis tests continuously, but that we did not detect any emergency pollutants, honestly. So, but that, of course, we take into consideration this kind of this kind of pollutant.
Right. Okay. There is another question here from Jane. Does the control panel require specialized personnel, like electrical engineer, or what's the level of requirement to be able to operate the panel?
Yeah. Yes. Answering to your question, Jane. Yes. It requires actually some specialized technician, which are already actually working in the plant. So it means that what we are trying to do is that together with a company that will provide the innovative treatment compact system, for example, enhancing their capacity and their knowledge through some trainings that will be performed before, during, and after the installation. Of course, to maintain sustainability of the activity of the action, and not harming the community itself, and also not harming for example the technician who will receive, of course, an innovative tool that in this case will not be able to run it. So in order to avoid the situation, we are definitely providing a capacity building.
Okay.
Thanks for your question. Very, very accurate, straight to the point.
Any other question for Giovanni? Any question? Right, I think in the absence of any other question, I think I would like to thank Giovanni Pedron for shuttling from one presentation to another presentation and having the time to handle all our questions. So thank you very much.
Thanks for actually for giving me your space.
I think that concludes this session. We have only two presentations. So enjoy the, long break, and then we'll see you at session 6C. Thank you, everyone.